Be still and know that I am with you. Be still and know that I am here. Be still and know that I am with you. Be still.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters and restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long.
And sleep no longer come. Remember all the words I said.
This psalm is very familiar to most of us. It was one of the first scriptures I memorized as a child. Even if you did not grow up in a church environment, you have likely heard this psalm referenced at a funeral because it brings us comfort even in times of sorrow. I found a line-by-line breakdown on Psalm 23 on a blog called Simply Coffee and Jesus. It inspired me and gave me a new appreciation for how comprehensive David was in sharing his heart. They assigned one word to each phrase of the psalm. My comments will be focused on the first part of verse 5. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. The word assigned to this phrase was hope. This surprised me. I haven't ever thought of having a table prepared in the presence of my enemies as hopeful. I guess I still thought of it as I did in my childhood when I memorized it, of actual people enemies like David had. After all, he was hiding in caves and waiting for people to kill him, and I certainly didn't have anything like that going on. I realized that enemies come in various forms and that my enemies are the more subtle ones like fear, anxiety, worry, or disappointment. In Psalm 23, our great shepherd covers us. He is our protector in testing, and he is faithful to guide us and supply all our needs and bring us to a place of rest and refreshment in him. And above all else, we get to have a relationship with him for all eternity.
And that gives me hope.
If morning never comes to be, be still, be still.
Gracious Father, whose blessed Son Jesus Christ came down from heaven to be the true bread which gives life to the world, evermore give us this bread that he may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
If no one is standing beside you, be still and know I am. Be still.